Field in Milwaukee, where the roof is closed for comfort. A good matchup here for you tonight between the St. Louis Cardinals and the Milwaukee Brewers.
And now, your 2021.
It's Brewers baseball on the show,
Milwaukee,
and it's coming up
Brewers.
Next. And now here is Tommy Edman, and we are set for baseball here this evening. Swung on, but fouled off to the left. Here now the 2-2. Finally, just wear him down as this one swung on and missed for the first out. The next to bat for St. Louis, Paul Goldschmidt. And a full count to Paul Goldschmidt, 3 balls and 2 strikes.
When you get yourself to a 3-1 count and you get a fastball, those are the ones you really want to punish. Couldn't get the bat on it, so we'll see if that comes back to haunt him.
Got him swinging on the fastball there. Paul Goldschmidt goes down for out number 2 in the top half. Down the first baseline, but this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2.
Put that in a memory bank. First time he breaks out a curveball right there, and it's a pretty good one.
And that misses, so it's a full count, 3-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. And we'll have the first base runner of the ball game here as that misses, and it's a 2-out walk.
The third baseman.
Stepping in for the Cardinals, Nolan Arenado. And we'll see if they can make him pay for the 2-out walk. Always considered a big no-no, of course. And he may be starting to lose the feel here as that misses for ball 4, and that's back-to-back walks now with 2 away. And this pitch misses for a ball. 2-1 now to Molina.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Yelich on the move. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. Here's Colton Wong now. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. Ready to deliver the 1-2. Lays off 2-2 now.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal. You can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he could go in right here.
And here's a slider. Strike 3 called, and that'll be the first out of the inning. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. Racing back, the right fielder to the track. And this ball is gone. No chance to make a play on that one. Stepping in now, Eduardo Escobar. Right side, but it's well fouled. One out, nobody on. Fastball too low, and that's ball 4. Next for Milwaukee, Narvaez, one in, one out, and one on here in the inning. High in the air out to center field. Long run for the center fielder. He gets there, and that's the second out. So a runner at first with 2 away, and that'll bring up Abisail Garcia. Escobar is off of first with 2 away. Drilled on the ground is short, and he'll go the short way to retire the side. Well, All set for the start of the inning and set to go as the switch hitting outfielder, Dylan Carlson. A chance here for the second baseman, Wong. Throw is in time for the first out of the second. Digging in next, Paul DeJong. Lifetime versus this arm. He's a 375 hitter. He's taken him deep once. Could have been 3-1. Instead, it's 2-2.
Hey, last two pitches back to back, off speed, then he's late on the fastball. He could pretty much do anything he wants right here on the mound.
In the air, down the line in left. Under it is Yelich, and there are two away now. And that'll bring up the former top prospect, Harrison Bader. He'll work on keeping this top of the second alive. 2-1. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
And this is where he's especially dangerous, because if you walk him, he can steal a base on you. But if you lay a fastball in there, he can take you deep, too.
And he looks at ball four now, so he's aboard, and you always have to worry about the threat of the steal when he's on base. Cardinals pitcher up there with a 1-2 count.
Hey, I still believe in my heart the best pitch is a well-executed fastball down and away, and that's exactly what that is.
Threw it right past him, a swing and a miss at the gas, and that ends the inning. Last half of the second set to go, and stepping up as the shortstop, Luis Urias. Drilled to the right side. And that is through into right field for a single. So the Brewers get their leadoff man aboard to start out the frame.
Batting seven, the first baseman.
Into the box now, 20. Daniel Vogelback. Vogelback behind, ball and two strikes. Well outside with the curveball for a ball. He's set. Here's the 2-2. On a line, that's a base hit.
Batting it, the center fielder.
To the plate now, Lorenzo Cain. In the dirt, and now let's see. Goes to third with it, and it's too late as he's in there. So now two men in scoring position. Urias on third. Vogelback is at second with nobody out. Hit back up the middle. Dive, but it's off his glove, and the run should score. And the run is in to score from third. It's a 2-0 ball game. And now this ball's going to wind up out of play. And that'll compound matters even further. 1-2 to the Brewers pitcher. Count still at 1-2. Goldschmidt trying to get there. And another foul ball. Runner at third here, nobody out. Another one sent foul. Trying to pick up that outside corner, but this misses, and it's back to even at two balls and two strikes.
After multiple pitches were fouled off, it gets a little.
And this is right past Molina and back to the screen. And the run will score on the wild pitch. My goodness. Hit hard on the ground to second. He's got it. And the throw to first is in time. One gone. So it's back to the top of the order now. And that'll bring up Colton Wong. Three runs already home here. And that one yanked just foul. A great pitch there as he couldn't get extended on that one, and he's down on strikes for the second out. So the bases are empty here with two gone. And that'll bring up Christian Yelich. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Outside with the fastball as the count moves to 2-1 now.
Wow, that's 40 pitches for him already. This doesn't have the makings of a start that he's going to go very deep.
A 3-1 count to the Brewers left fielder. Lifted down the line in left. And this will wind up a foul ball.
It's going to be back to some serious tee work if he can't put that pitch in play right in his wheelhouse.
Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Lifted the other way down the left field line. O'Neill waits on it, and the inning is over. Digging in, the switch hitter, Tommy Edman, 0-for-1 for him here in this one.
They've gotten a gut punch to start this game. There's no doubt about this, but that's when you have to turn the scoreboards off. Everybody do their job one at bat at a time.
Two balls and a strike to count. Good fastball down around the knees there, taken for a strike. And it's fouled away. Fouled off. Looking to punch him out again. The pitch.
These are the kind of ABs, regardless of the outcome, you go back to the dugout as the offensive player, and your teammates are loving on you for making that pitcher work and battling it out.
And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin inning number three. Cardinals have been held out of the hit column here. Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two.
Sometimes you got to be aggressive offensively, but sometimes you just let the pitcher dig his own grave. Patience and discipline seem to be the way to go right here.
2-2. Pitch outside. The throw way late, and he's in there easily at second. A runner at second. Nobody out. And here's a ball in the air now, carrying a bit out toward right center. It's in there, and the Cardinals look to have an extra base hit on their first hit of the game. And the runner scores from second as they chip into the deficit here. Into the box, Tyler O'Neill tried to crush that ball and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes. Here now the 2-2. And he fouls this one off.
Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to go a little bit further outside the zone. Three foul balls in a row. He wants to get a swing and a miss on this next pitch.
3-2 now. He's set, and the payoff pitch. Down the left field line and deep. And this will wind up a foul ball. The 3-2 one more time. Nope, and that's low, ball four. And that'll bring in Nolan Arenado. He drew a base on balls his first time up. The 3-1. Full count now, 3-2. At second, Goldschmidt, now the pitch. Goldschmidt on second, O'Neill at first with no outs. Seared down the first baseline. But this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2.
You can really tell they're trying to keep the ball in on this big slugger right here.
Is that an effort to keep him from getting extended, do you think?
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt. But he might spin the win if he starts looking for it in there.
Swing and a miss as he ran that in on him. A ball and two strikes. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side, and that's going to land foul. And a swing and a miss on a huge first out there as he sets him down swinging with the bases loaded. Bases are loaded with only one out. Fouled away. The 1-2 is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. So now here is Paul DeJong. Flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0 for 1 so far.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
They try to come in with the fastball, but it's too far in, and it's even at 2-2. Got him. So the damage winds up not being as bad as it could have been, as they'll strand the bases loaded. The side is retired. So here's Eduardo Escobar as we move on to the bottom of inning number 3. Back up the middle and in for a base hit.
Up next to Milwaukee, the catcher.
In now, Narvaez. This is hit the other way out toward left field. O'Neill waits on it, makes the play, one away. So here is Avisaíl Garcia, 0 for 1 here in the early going.
Avisaíl Garcia.
Oh, and this is hit high and deep out to left. He leaps, but he can't get it. It's down for extra bases.
Now batting, shortstop, Luis Urias.
So now to the plate, Luis Urias. Not quick enough that time, and he's lucky to get another chance. Count remains full. And this misses for ball 4. The second walk he surrendered here in the first 3 innings. Digging in now for the Brewers, Daniel Vogelbach. He singled and scored in his first appearance in this one. And the curveball bounces here, but a good job behind the plate to keep it at arm's length. And this ball is crushed deep down the right field line. Would have been a grand slam. Instead, it's a foul ball.
Ah, man, just a hair early on that one and just pulled it foul. He's going to have to find a way to refocus. Not easy to continue an AB after you just went deep foul.
And again, he's unable to keep it fair, but he's putting together quite a battle at the plate.
Hey, 3 foul balls in a row right here, searching for that put-away stuff.
And a strike 3 called. My gracious, what a pitch with the bases loaded, and there are 2 away now.
Lorenzo King.
Swing, and he launches this one to deep left field. O'Neill looks up. Gone! It's a grand slam. Kwang Young Kim is going to come on to pitch here, and in just the 3rd inning, you have to think he'll be asked to eat some innings. At the plate now, Freddy Peralta. Pitch is popped up, and no one will get this one. The 1-2.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
And he strikes him out here, so he's able to stop the bleeding a bit as the side is retired. So that'll bring in Harrison Bader. Worked a walk in his first plate appearance. And he got him. So in now is the Cardinals pitcher, Kwang Young Kim. One run, just one hit, one error for the Cardinals to this point. And it's fouled away.
Wow, that's 4 straight K's. He's knocking them down. He's looking for number 5 right here. You could tell this guy on the mound, he is pitching with a whole lot of confidence in this one.
There to play it is Garcia, and that becomes out number 2. So next to bat will be Tommy Edman. Comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ball game. 2-1. little early, and now it's even at 2-2. Trying to send him packing for the second time. Here's one that misses inside, and the count's run full now, 3-2.
That's a great take right there. Great pitch recognition to let that one go. Opposite handed, that's coming across the plate. You might think you got a shot to stay inside that one.
Daniel Norris takes over here with a runner at first and two gone in the inning. Two out with the man at first. A swing and a ground ball to third. And as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and set to go is the second baseman, Colton Wong. The 1-1. Fouled off. Ready to deliver the 1-2. And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one.
Well, left fielder,
next up, Christian Yelich. A hit and two at bats for him at this point in the ballgame. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Into the windup and the pitch. Got him to reach for it there as this is grounded to short. And there's out number two. Eduardo Escobar standing in.
Number five, Eduardo Escobar.
Hit hard on the ground to the right. And this will get through into right, and he's aboard with a single.
Up next to Milwaukee, the catcher.
Stepping in now, Omar Narvaez. The count is 2-2 to the Brewers catcher.
Hey, if he's going to get swings and misses at balls up and out of the zone, he's going to continue to go there.
Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. Throw over to first, and he has to dive, but he's back in easily. Here's another 2-2. Slider whiffed on for strike three. A great pitch to put an end to the inning. Into the box, Tyler O'Neill. He'll start off the fifth in this one. Three and one to the Cardinals left fielder.
Hey, if you're going to throw a pitch like that to this guy, that's right where you want to miss. Any lower, and he'll probably make you pay for it.
And here's a ball hit in the air. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. And a good eye here as he takes ball four, and it's a base on balls to lead off the fifth inning. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Nolan Arenado. It was a walk in his last trip. Not close with the off-speed pitch taken for a ball.
This situation right here reminds me of sitting on the bench talking to John Smoltz, Hall of Famer. He would always say, even though the situation looked bad, a pitcher is one pitch away from getting himself out of a tough jam.
O'Neill gets his lead at first, nobody out. Oh, and he misses it.
Now that
into the box now, Yadier Molina, and he lays off upstairs, but it's ruled a strike, and he can't believe it. 1-2. 2-2 to the Cardinals catcher. Ready with the 2-2. Hit on the ground to third. Wong for one. Back to first, and they'll get the slow-footed Molina. It's a double play. So base is empty now after the double play. And coming forward is the switch-hitting outfielder, Dylan Carlson. And he fouls this one off. Line towards center field. And a base hit, and that'll get the run in from third.
The batter, number 11.
To the plate now, Paul DeJong. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. Kane going back at the track. A dive, and he brings it in. And on a fantastic play, the inning is over. Bottom of the inning now. And coming forward, the veteran outfielder, Avisail Garcia. The 1-1 home. Lifted down the line and left. But this is going to wind up a foul ball. Here comes the 1-2. Is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. So one gone in the Milwaukee fifth. And that'll bring Luis Urias to the plate. Now the 2-1. Grounder down the line at third. But this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2.
You can definitely tell with that foul off right there that he's picking up spin on this pitcher's off-speed stuff. Maybe expect a fastball on this next one.
Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. Hit down the third baseline. And that finds its way through for a base hit.
Now batter, number 20.
Into the box, Daniel Vogelbach. And they'll try to stay out of the double play here as he lays this one down. And they'll put the tag on him going to first, but the sacrifice is successful. So the next to bat will be Lorenzo Cain. He's got hits in both of his at-bats so far in this one. Look into Molina, now the 1-1. Lays off the breaking pitch, and it's three balls and a strike.
Here's the game within the game. You have a better matchup on deck. You got a 3-1 count in this situation. Don't be afraid to put him on base and attack the next guy.
Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. Top half of the sixth about to get started. And in to bat next, one of the fastest players in all of baseball, Harrison Bader. High in the air down the right field line. On the move is Garcia. And no one will track it down. Two-two pitch is fouled away. Now the pitch, and a check swing here, but the bat clearly breaks the plane as he's set down for the first out. Andrew Kisner will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher. Here's the 2-1 home. Can't find the zone there, and it's 3-1. And he popped him up. Back into foul territory behind first, and no one can get there. It's a foul ball. 3-2 pitch. This one's flared off to the right side. Wong onto the grass. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out. That brings in Tommy Edman. It was a walk in his last trip. The 1-1. The 1-2. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side. Vogelbach in foul ground. And he lays out, but he can't make the play. We'll do it again. And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight. Daniel Ponce de Leon enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth. Jace Peterson is going to come off the bench as he'll be asked to lead off the bottom of inning number six.
Peterson.
The 1-1. Peterson has had his trouble in these matchups, facing right-handed pitching, that is. He shows a lot more prowess against the southpaws. Slider can't find the zone here, and he's behind now 3-1. That's popped up. Arenado trying to get there, and this is going to be a foul ball. And that one misses, so the leadoff man will head down to first on ball four to start the bottom of the sixth.
The second base.
So the lineup flips over and digging in, Colton Wong. Three at-bats for him in this one, all ending with him going down on strikes. Into the corner and slicing foul. Peterson aboard here at first with nobody out. Good job going down and hanging with it that time. The next 3-2. Hit in the air down the right field line. But this is going to wind up a foul ball. The next 3-2. Fly ball right down the line and left. Left fielder giving chase, and he tracks it down. Nice play for the first out. Next to hit is Christian Yelich. Lifetime against this particular arm. He's hitless in six tries. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. Pulled hard, but it's foul down the first base side. 8 runs, 9 hits, and no errors on the Milwaukee line score so far. Runners on the move for second. Pitch inside, the throw, and it's not in time as he's in well ahead of the throw. Fouled away. Lifted the other way to left center. Chasing after it is O'Neill. He makes the play. Really had to hustle to get to that one. Two gone now. Now it'll be Eduardo Escobar. Two base hits, both singles to this point.
Escobar.
The 3-1 pitch. And it's fouled away. 3-2 pitch. Making him sweat out there. The 7th pitch coming up. And look out. That's in very tight, and it's ball four.
Up next,
hit, Narvaez. No hits in 3 tries so far. He's struck out once. 1-1. Started to go around there. Looked like he held up in time. No. Strike 2, says the third base umpire. He's set, and the 1-2 pitch. In the dirt, but swung on and missed. And that ends the inning. Miguel Sanchez is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7. 7th inning ready to roll, and stepping in the power hitting first baseman Paul Goldschmidt. The 2-1. High and deep down the left field line. But this will wind up being a foul ball.
He got the fastball where he wanted and just pulled off of it.
Popped him up. Vogelback has room in foul territory. One down. One gone for the Redbirds in the 7th. And into bat next will be Tyler O'Neill. Bases are empty. One man out. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. 2 strikes on him now. Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup.
Hey, you guys know me. Hitting's a process of elimination, and I'm eliminating the changeup this next pitch. I'm on everything else.
Had to wait back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now. And he takes ball four again, and they clearly just don't want any part of him in this one. Next, it'll be Nolan Arenado. Now the 2-1 pitch is blasted out to left center. This one's deep and not coming back. Gone! Standing in now, Yadier Molina lofted in the air out toward right center. Garcia coming on. He makes the running play. Two down. Striding in is Dylan Carlson. He delivered an RBI single in his last trip. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
It's clear he just hasn't been able to find any rhythm out there. Pretty much unable to hit any of his spots, and now he's at 3-1, and he's put him into another great hitting count.
Yelich gets under it and makes the catch to end the inning.
For the traditional seventh inning stretch.
Genesis Cabrera gets the call from the pen to take the ball for the home seventh. So now into the box is Avisail Garcia, struck out in his last trip to the plate. The 1-1 is taken for ball two.
Sitting in a good spot right here. Two ball, one strike count is yet to see a fastball. Have to be sitting on one right here.
Good fastball as he gets the swing and a miss.
Big fastball is definitely this guy's MO coming out of the bullpen.
On the ground for the shortstop, DeYoung. Throw to first is in time for the first out. One away for the Brewers in their half of the seventh. And stepping into the box will be Luis Urias. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and it's 1-2. And oh, a big rip at the curveball, but he didn't get it, and he becomes the second casualty of the inning. Next to dig in, Daniel Vogelbach. He laid down a sacrifice bunt in his last trip.
And not easy to do in today's game. High velocity, exploding breaking stuff. He executed that sack bunt perfectly.
Protecting with two strikes, went out of the zone that time, but he stays alive. And he lays off, so it's full now, 3-2. Chopped weakly to the left. The next 3-2. Curveball, but a good job to lay off, and he works out the free pass.
The center fielder.
Digging in will be Lorenzo Cain, man at first after the two-out walk. Swing and a screamer, but this one's not going to stay fair. Hit out towards second. And the inning will continue as that's through for a two-out hit. Number 33 will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here. Vogelbach over at second. Kane on at first with two down. Fastball runs in tight here, and it's 2-1.
He's got a couple of pitches to deal with right here, but he's starting to lose command of his pitches. It might be time to take a step back and try to refocus on making some good pitches.
Two balls and two strikes now. Got him swinging as he runs the fastball by him to end the inning. Hunter Strickland has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth. Ready to begin the eighth, and coming forward now is the shortstop, Paul DeJong. Can't keep that one fair, and now the count's full. Now the 3-2 pitch. Hit in the air to left. Yelich is under it. Looks it into his glove, and there's one gone. Now to the plate, Harrison Bader. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
Ball taken there. 2-1 now. And now pitch on the way. Fastball is looked at for strike two.
He'll be fine coming out of the bullpen in this one if he can keep the ball around the knees like that.
He sends it out to left field. Well hit. And that one is gone. Edmundo Sosa will get a shot here as a pinch hitter. Little bit outside, 2-1. As we near the end of this one, it's clear the long ball has played a big role in today's outcome. Dan Dero, what are your final thoughts on what we've seen?
Yeah, just non-competitive pitches in some big situations, Dan, and the offense took full advantage.
Yeah, you know, Dero, one of the things about pitching is you want to have location, and it was obvious in this one today that the pitchers weren't on point, and what happens when that happens? Hitters make you pay, and the long ball was a big part of this one here.
Now the 1-1 pitch. Hit down the line at first, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. Pitch on the way. Popped up. Two out, nobody on. Lays off the 1-2 changeup, and he's worked it back to 2-2. And he tries to get him to reach for it, but it stays outside, 3-2.
You know, you don't always have to straight challenge a guy on a 3-2 count. With the three-run lead, no one on base, this is the perfect situation to do it. No reason to nibble and possibly set up a big inning.
And he takes ball four again, and they clearly just don't want any part of him in this one. Josh Hader is called upon with two out in the eighth as he's asked to complete a four-out save. Paul Goldschmidt will be the first to greet him here as he stands in with a runner at first and two away. And this ball runs away for ball two, 2-1. Off-speed pitch misses here, and he runs it to 3-1.
Well, tying run on deck, he should get something really good to hit right here in a 3-1 count. I'd be sitting on a fastball middle in.
Oh, and this one's driven the other way and deep to the corner. And he gets there, makes the running play, and that ends the inning. Andrew Miller is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth. Bottom of inning number eight set to go, and that'll bring up Colton Wong. Now here's the pitch. Lays off the slider that time, 2-1. Miller, a 6'7" left-hander. This is his 16th season at the major league level, and obviously that alone reflects the incredible career he's put together.
Yeah, Matty, no kidding right there. I'll tell you what, the grind to get to the big leagues is so hard. Guys just want, they just want to spend a month, a day in the big leagues. So to put yourself here for 12 years screams to your ability to adjust and be a great teammate.
And he'll strike out here yet again, as it's been a ballgame to forget thus far. Four strikeouts.
Now batting, left fielder, Christian.
Look into Molina, now the 1-1. Strike two swinging just out in front of the slider. Fastball, and ooh, that ran in and drilled him. Now at the plate, here is Eduardo Escobar.
Now batting, third baseman, Eduardo Escobar.
And now they've got him picked off. They slap the tag on him, and he is out at second base. Bases are empty here with two men out. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. Pitch on the way. Fouled off. The next 1-2 pitch.
Nope. The classic back foot slider right there with two strikes. Usually gets a ton of swing and misses. Nice layoff right there. Fight for another pitch.
Sent on the ground out to second. Over to first, and that retires the side. Now into the box, Tyler O'Neill, lifetime in this matchup. He's hitless in three at-bats. Right side. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway. Here's Nolan Arenado. He went deep for a two-run homer in his previous at-bat.
Well, Matt, this is one of the problems. This guy's a good fastball, particularly low fastball hitter. It doesn't matter how hard or how low you throw it. That's right into this wheelhouse. What you want to do with this guy is move the ball from the belt up to get him to chase something that maybe he'll pop up in the infield.
Cardinals down to their final strike here. St. Louis, good night.
Yeah, they needed him a little bit earlier in this one, but he takes the mound in the eighth and records the final four outs. Four out save, job well done.
8-5 tonight. Milwaukee jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. Daniel Norris takes home the win. Jake Woodford allowed 7 earned runs to cross the plate in the losing effort. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
The final line score for our ball game tonight. For the victorious Brewers, 8 runs, 10 hits, no errors. They left 7 men on base. For St. Louis, 5 runs on 5.